And it's made in a polyester base, you can really wash it around, so. He actually paints with that directly on the overhead projector film. And then he can take away and scumble in and out. And then when the image looks right, he folds it up to the window, put it right on the image, and the image looks right. Then he lets it dry, and he put it face down, contact print, and we get an exact replica of this drawing. You can see it's sensitive. He paint, this is an etching.
Right.
So originally it was done with an ink drawing on plastic. You can also draw directly on hot press illustration board to get a good scan. It doesn't work to use a pencil on a texture paper, because that's difficult to copy. So there's some substrates that work best for your impression. So we deal a lot with the mechanics of scanners and the mechanics of, you know, all the zero machines.
So Michael Jameson,
and again, technically, actually, in terms of the final print, that is completely a matching as much as any other matching that Fred Red ever did. It has the same ink, the same kind of line, the same white beam, the same crust, the same paper. So it's just the plate is made photographically instead of through acid. So the etching is done with water. Water right out of the sink. So that's one comment. Here's another interesting piece. Some artists will just simply take an object, put it on the Xerox machine or their scanner and scan it. And out comes the transparency on the other to make a print. So this is an example of that. These are two objects laid face down on a Xerox machine. Put the face down just like we used to do with our butts and faces. And just if you like the print, then you put in a piece of transparency, you get a copy, face down, and there it goes. So that happens when you print it in colored ink. This is one color. Brownie.
You see the, some of the, like the pictures here, that's got a higher degree of resolution than we get from zero.
Well, because yes, yeah, inkjet printers or laser printers are fine. And actually, some Xerox machines are actually scanners, color Xerox machines. And they can be used to get a better quality. But this guy is Mr. Mac, you know. He's also, you know, deals with.
Can you increase the amount of transparency for you with that degree of resolution?
Yes. I cannot improve on his. In fact, that's the struggle we went through for 5 years. Is his lines were so difficult that if the pixel's missing, it's ruined.
Yeah.
You know, if I get one spot that doesn't get ink in it, it's like going, oh, there's a white spot there. So, you know, we struggled through it until finally, in a way, I was doing, you know, less technically, you know, dumb down. And of course, he couldn't even try, he couldn't, but I got better, and we figured it out, and these engineers helping us, and we got to where, but once the plates are made, the printing is a problem that's the same problem in the last 5 years.
Yeah.
Can you make it? Is it incorrect? Is it warm enough? That's all. That I got down. Getting the plates to read his transparency correctly, that took some time. We had to figure out, you know, what overhead projector film we could rely on and what didn't work, what printers worked best. And, you know, we went through that, and things are constantly changing. Printers, you know, the old ones, so. This is a dance we're doing, and we're up with it.
So that line quality is exceptional and not.
No, it's I couldn't do it anything.
You can do it again.
I wouldn't have shown you. I don't want to get into it. No, it's. Here's another. This is an artist who's a photographer. She took her own existing images in Photoshop, made a transparency, and then combined them with a second transparency. She sandwiched the transparencies that whether it's Black Ink or not, these whole other place are especially known for their beautiful glass, as where as their articulated graphic, like as in text, it's commonly used in text. Have you done something with your glass? Good. Everything?
Everything.
Yourself or all the printers?
Both.
Great, great. Well, if you know, you can maybe we can talk later.
Oh, I'm learning.
Okay.
I'm here for this.
All right, thank you. I want to show you one other piece. Same artist, but I want you to note that she's stuck with it, you know, and does it herself. I don't need these people's plates for them, but I'm there to support. I also don't get any signings, obviously. So this was done, you know, the second round, and this was really what she was looking for. It's her own transparency is made to get the best look that she could. It's not going to look like a photograph, so we've done a lot of photography. It's a, you know, it's a scary thing to go in, and we can't control your images. Like, it's not a photograph. And I eventually suggest that everybody come through and try something when they have time, and then give up their old images and go out for something and shoot just for this medium. Just like we've got a different image, if you have a chisel and a big piece of wood, you wouldn't have that same image and composition, and that's what we're looking for. So, black, articulated. Here's a, so this one is here. Technically, this is something we can do. Get this romantic glow, we can use it, you know, for things, whatever. But they are not photographs, they are etchings. But they do they have a beauty, I think, in the way that photographs can be attractive. This is a play by this first Calvin as an attorney, actually. A lot of people have jobs and don't get into art until they're in their 50s. This is a plate that's made by, without a transparency, she's gone on the plate and painted the plate with water. Before they're exposed to the lights, the plates will melt in water. So if you sneeze on your plate, then you sneeze, you don't sneeze there. Wonderful, just water up. So she's actually painted with a wet brush. I should know he's done things, and he also he's related to sand. He's related to sand because they're you know, they're little digital elements that have a certain personality that fascinates him, as are bubbles. So we did a series of prints where he, you know, was blowing bubbles, and they're building up and popping, and of course he couldn't capture the bubble because it's all TV, so that went out the window. And then sand, he was forming these special tubes that pour the sand different patterns into crystal spill. We made some plates on that. That didn't make it to the end, but he did a huge hanging pendulum that was attached to the roof of our warehouse. And he swung this huge pendulum that had a dripping, and had a huge lead tube with a syringe, and was splashing ink that was going across the plates like this. And, you know, he was interested in the splash effects, and, you know, so he was, you know, people would go, oh, like, this is, and then after painting on the plate, she printed it, she said, oh, that's boring. So then she went in with an exact amount and just packed up the plate. And dry point, of course, is a great, beautiful thing, and this is probably one of the most unattractive dry point lines that can be made. But nonetheless, I've been showing you that to show that you can't. It is a plastic coating on steel, but you can cut into it and hack at it and make it out for you. This is the same artist. She would go running with the dog at the beach before coming to class, and she would pick up objects and bring them back. So this happened to be a feather. This feather was laid directly on the plate, piece of glass over it, put in the sun, and then processed. And then she later printed it. This is just a small Kim Silver, which I think really shows you, it's a good example of how the images, we always print them up in black and white to look at them technically, make sure you've got what you wanted. But then colors, obviously, through some colored paper and colored ink, is a pretty, even just with one color change, is a, this should be a great sort of possibility.
And you said the prints, are they all to be black and white, or is it a one color process?
One color.
Any color?
Black, red, any color you want, you can match it. Yeah. So, I would show you much color with it, but that is the good. Yeah. And, you know, we can do any color. And we will mix, that's part of what I'll do with you when you come up and work, is I'll get, we've got to figure out the color too. First, we have to plate make correctly. That could take 4 or 5 tries, or something that happens immediately. We'll be processing plates, and then once the image is correct, you say, all right, now, let's get your color out, we'll proof it up in black, and then when it's ready, we switch the color. And there's things we have to talk about. So some colors need, for better or worse, a tint on the white space. I talk a little bit about color and its opportunities and problems as well. Here is a good example of what I want to talk about in terms of tinting your glass. We're able to get, in the similar way that they do in photography, a duotone, where the top color, which is where it's dense and thick and you squeeze it out of the tube, looks black. But the bottom color, which is a vague tint, reveals chroma. So you end up getting what looks like a black and sort of a beige colored image. And when it's printed on white paper, you get saturation. Black line and white. That happens in drawings.